Hey there, folks. This is DMC Jedi Man Gaming. Welcome back to part 3 of LEGO Star Wars The Skywalker Saga. We are picking off where we left off. We're in Mos Eisley Spaceport. You will never find a more wretched hive of scum and villainy. So, before I get started, don't forget, if you like my content, be sure to like and subscribe. But let's get back on into this. Alright, I'm assuming we're heading for the cantina. I'll follow the markers to where I need to.
Halt. Let's see your identification. And bring those droids over here.
An Imperial checkpoint. Now what?
I'll handle this, Luke.
Fun little fact. The sand trooper that Obi-Wan used the mind trick on was voiced by Terry McGovern, who's better known as voicing Launchpad from Darkwing Duck and DuckTales. That is awesome. Right.
These aren't the droids you're looking for.
These aren't the droids we're looking for.
I can't understand how we got past those troopers. I thought we were done for.
The Force can have a strong influence on the weak-minded. Now, let's make our way to that cantina. We need to find our pilot.
Right here. Chalmun's Cantina. Run during the day by Chalmun and Werber, the bartender. And the evening bartender is Akmina. She's from the Star Wars Holiday Special. Hashtag Disney release the holiday special.
Hey, you're droids. They'll have to wait outside. We don't want them here.
We should inquire about
that
a pilot to take us to Alderaan.
Not most likely.
All right, let's ask around.
He's the one that usually says that. That's also not Werher. Where is Werher? Seriously, they didn't put Werher in the game? Next thing you'll tell me, Ro Hood isn't in here either. That's the Cantina Band. They're fifth musicians led by Sir Sigrun Dien. Other members include Ekbel Giant, Tech Mo. Trying to remember the other ones. I had all their cards from the Decipher card game. I always like to call them the Butthead Musicians because of the big crack on their head that looks like the butt. We've got some Grams in here. We got some Mon Calamari. We got DeLorean. We got a fairly recognizable Wookiee, some Rodians, some Aqualish, Ponga Bulba and Dr. Evazon, see a Twilight. Let's talk to this brain.
You're looking for a smuggler. You might be looking for one of Jabba's guys then. I seen one walk in here earlier with his big furry friend over there.
Someone who can help us get to Alderaan. Can pay. Take me to it.
Don't say Han's not first. So Greedo seems to have survived his encounter this time.
Han Solo. I'm captain of
the
Millennium Falcon.
Noga.
Chewie here tells me you're looking for passage to the Alderaan system.
Yes, indeed. If it's a fast ship.
She's fast enough for you, old man. What's the cargo?
Only passengers, myself, the boy, two droids, and no questions asked.
Okay, you guys got yourselves a ship. We'll leave as soon as you're ready. Docking Bay 94.
94.
It's on the docking bay 94 now. That's a droid detector, by the way. That's what alerted the cantina staff to the droid entry. They didn't say anything.
All right, let's go find
they
this docking bay.
Something, but
excuse me, sir, but according to R2, docking bay 94 is on the other side of this settlement.
Luke, make sure you are well prepared before we leave.
Yeah, in other words, do what you need to, because you're not coming back to Tatooine again. At least not until you unlock hyperspace travel. I wonder. Okay, there's one of those data cards here, too. So... Is that the Dragover Queen? I probably completely butchered that pronunciation, but if that's what I think it is... Okay, I cannot get in there... that way... I need to find and smash 7 more. Yeah, I'm not sure if I'm gonna get much done in this episode either, since I really, really want to find what I need for stud signs too. Oh, there's another one of those guys that I need. Let's see if I can get a good vantage where the next ones are. Oh, I bet it's wherever the smoke is. Well, one way to find out.
The old Bantha in front of the door trick. Classic.
Ah! One over here. One of those smoke things. Thinking that would lead me to where those things to destroy are, but it does not appear. Okay, Obi-Wan got off the thing anyway, so...
Show's over, folks. Guess we gotta go back to our tyrannical
I'll just figure that out on my own.
Well, we never get to have any fun.
The little things you're seeing, by the way, running around are called stones. In. I'm going to try and get this level done, and then that'll be it for this episode.
What a piece of junk!
She may not look like much, but she's got it where it counts, kid.
Chewie, yeah. What is this? I told you to get her ready.
A late lunch?
Hey,
we gotta be somewhere.
Stop that ship!
Fun little fact, originally, I don't think I intended to do that, I'll take it though.
Get the cockpit, the cannon, and the sensor dish. Got that furball?
Yes, Artu. We can get the stairlift into position.
Oh. Let's grab as much of those studs here as I can. Anyway, what I was gonna say before I got blown up in the explosion was a fun little fact is the troopers that attacked us, one of those was Davin Felt. I probably mispronounced that, by the way. Basically, he was a sand trooper, or sand trooper, that turned on the Empire and shot his commander in the back when the Falcons escaped. It was part of the expanded universe, though. Fortunately, that impossible thing is no longer canon. Going through getting all the studs I can first, because this is a level with true Jedi status. So I want as much done as I can in here before fighting. Here you are too, but I've got a mission besides what I gotta do here. Like, the more stuff I can destroy. Oh, okay. That probably would have helped me, switch to loot. Yeah. What, no achievement for wearing a stormtrooper armor? I'm gonna go back to that little Imperial thing I saw. So, up, up, down. Right, that code has been entered. A Kyber brick for getting the first for 3 status done. Thank you. like I need to get a gaunt droid on. I know I heard a gaunt droid somewhere. Probably the cockpit. And yes, I know that was probably the best from coming through the door, but I want the stuff. Good job, R2. Not sure what that did. Stand next to that when it blew. So I've already got two. Well, I got one bar done, and I'm almost at the second one. True status doesn't seem to be too hard to get, but I still want those stud multipliers a lot sooner than later. The sooner I get them, the more chance I'll be able to start racing in studs quickly. So far though, this game has exceeded my expectations. Oh, there's another R2 thing, so do that first. Alright. Oh. Oh! Okay, I see. That just gives another set of stormtrooper armor should be avoided. Okay. donk droid. I know we got something we had to put him on, so let's go do that. Yep, it was just coming over here. Okay, what is this? Some sort of a conveyor. Oh! Minikit dispenser! Nice! Got one mini-kit piece in this level. Can't destroy that, though. Where are you? There's this thing back here that I'm gonna try to use. I may not be able to use it with Stormtrooper. Hooray, I had forgotten how I was supposed to do this. There we go. A blue stud there. Oh, another mini kit. That's now 2 of 5. Wonder if I can find them all in this level. Probably not. I'll probably have to have free play for that. Okay, let's start checking out the area here. Cockpit is assembled. Droids right here. Okay, well.
Gonna fix herself.
Yeah, I know. Oh. looks like we're about at the half hour mark, but I'm gonna finish this level before.
Careful with that copter! Don't use my dice.
Yeah. Well, our trap's working.
Are there always this many stormtroopers in Mos Eisley?
I don't know. I usually try and avoid them.
Halt! Prepare to be eliminated.
That's the cockpit and the quad laser cannon put together.
Nearly ready. Shoot! Keep at it!
Finish that first bit of repair. Another gaunt droid. No, I saw a place to use. Just want to get the true meter filled up here. It actually looks like a lot of my episodes will probably be about 40 minutes. Damn. Another little bit of interesting trivia right there. That is a YT-1300 Draeger, otherwise known as the Millennium Falcon specifically. It originally belonged to Lando Calrissian until Han Solo won it from him in a game of Sabacc. Number 3! Sweet! So that's now 3 of 5. If I can find the other two, we'll have the whole mini kit. Blown up. But I do want the studs. There we go, true Jedi status. Make sure I didn't miss anything, and I'll get the sensor dish, which is also sometimes called a rectenna. I'll get that assembled, and the Falcon will be able to escape off of Tatooine. Okay, and this is where we came up. Okay, it doesn't look like we can use that, but I can, however, get up to here. There we go.
Chewbacca, the new sensor dish is ready for installation.
Okay.
We gotta cover Chewie.
That's mini kit piece number 4. If all of the doors open and every single one has them, nothing there. I am going to check them all though. Oh. Oh, I will take that purple stud. That's one moving on there. Yeah, I'm just checking all the doors. Once I'm done with them, I'll switch over to R2 and see what I can do there. The last of them. Okay. There's our... Wait! Where are you going? Come back! Alright, this one's complicated one. Alright, what does that do? Ah, that closes all the doors. Falcon's been repaired.
Keep going. Is that everything?
Of course we can get inside, wise guy.
Get that ramp over. It won't last much longer if we don't get that ramp down.
I bet the,
We need to get out of here on one
of these. Rather than 20,000 fools. Okay, so how do I get to the first one? Yeah, first one. I know what 2 out of 3 means usually, but I don't know what means in context of this. Sorry, R2. side of where that guy was. So, I'm pretty sure the last kneecap piece is underneath the bowel. I'm not entirely sure how to get there, so...
Chewie, get us out of here!
There we go.
They were the droids we were looking for.
Go strap yourselves in. I'm gonna make the jump to light speed.
Whoa! Careful when you're swinging that thing, Luke.
Looks like we're coming up on Alderaan.
What?
What's left of it?
Where is it?
Destroyed by the Empire.
He's heading for that
There's
small moon.
Fire?
That's no moon.
And
it's a space station.
We're caught in a tractor beam. It's pulling us in.
You can't win, but there are alternatives to fighting.
There's no one on board, sir.
Send a scanning crew aboard. I want every part of this ship checked.
Yes, sir.
I sense
I'm pretty sure that's who Captain
is. Presence I have not felt since.
Huh?
Yes, yes, no. Yes, yes, that's... Yes. So familiar.
Now destroyed with a stormtrooper.
This is ridiculous. Even if I could take off, I'd never get past the tractor beam.
Leave that to me.
So, that's level 2, hunk of jump complete. Let's see what we got. Obviously, free play has been unlocked. We got true Jedi status once again. Grand total of 103,000 studs. Okay, in terms of the challenges, we got Don't Get Cocky and Chewie Get Us Out of Here. Mini kits we almost built with. Oh! Mini Millennium Falcon! Oh, so close to having the Mini Millennium Falcon. In terms of characters and ships, we got Han Solo, Episode 4, Sand Trooper Commander, Sand Trooper Sergeant, Millennium Falcon Episode 4 through 6. I think the ones that are dark are ones I have to buy at some point, but they're unlocked to buy. The ones that are, you know, full color are ones that we actually have.
Given I am not the skies like you are, it would be wise for me to keep my distance from this fellow to avoid raising suspicion.
So, we now are on the Death Star. This is where we're going to leave this episode, though. I hope you enjoyed this one. Looks like every single episode I do is going to be around 50 minutes. I was hoping for them to be more like a half hour, but there's just so much to do and see. It's going to be hard to... It's going to be hard to do it, you know, without, you know, going over. But this has been DMC Jedi Man Gaming. I hope you enjoyed this. Tune in tomorrow for part 3, where I will be venturing deep into the heart of the Death Star and rescuing a certain princess. Anyway, this has been DMC Jedi Man, and I am going to be signing out. Peace!